Namaste, beautiful yogis. Welcome to Ali Kamenova Yoga. I'm Ali, and today we are going to do a coffee cup vinyasa flow in the ClairAlience series. Today's class is coffee, ClairAlience, and today's class is brought to you by my favorite EMF protection device, which is AresTech. It is a device that I wear everywhere outside, wherever I go. The human body in a modern society is bombarded every single day by an invisible threat called EMR, or electromagnetic radiation. EMR is emitted by nearly every piece of electrical equipment and technology that we possess, and it is having a negative effect on our bodies, especially our central nervous system, and may manifest itself in headaches, insomnia, dizziness, increased stress, neurosis, and many other physiological ailments. Our bodies have no natural resistance to this exponential increase in EMR in our modern society. So American Ares Technologies has developed something to counter its effects on the human body. AresTech offers live-tuned EMR modulation technology that reduces the effects of electromagnetic radiation emitted by data-transmitting electronics such as cell phones, wireless earpieces, wireless headsets, computers, laptops, monitors, smart TVs, baby monitors, Wi-Fi routers, and more. The nanoprocessors in the device restructures and transforms electromagnetic field haze into a more biologically compatible form. For December, they have the more you shop, the more you save sale. Plus, on top of the sale, you can use my discount code AliKamenova10 for an additional 10% on top of the sale off. The sale is, if you buy two devices, you get 20% off. If you buy three devices, 30% off. If you buy four devices, 40% off. It's the best sale of the year, and it's perfect for your thoughtful Christmas gifts. Until December 15th, which is just 2 days left, you have a secret Santa code, AliK, all capital letters, that you can use, just 2 days left on that one. After December, you can still use my coupon code AliKamenova10, that is an evergreen code, and it gives you 10% additional discount. So if you're looking to get this device for December, I have special codes, coupon codes for December and ongoing coupon code beyond December. So take advantage of them. I'll list them all in the description box below. For today's class, I would ask you to prepare your yoga block or a Pilates ball. The class will work without this, but if you have a yoga block, prepare it because it adds a little bit of added resistance for the pelvic floor and inner thighs muscles and the core, which will be later in the class. The class, again, will work without those props, but if you have a yoga block or a small size Pilates ball, that will work, or even a little pillow, yoga pillow. ClairAlience, I mentioned it in the previous class on YouTube, but it is an extra sense. It's the psychic sense of smell, and it is something that we can use on our healing journey. In general, developing the psychic senses can help us on our healing journey, and there has to be a disclaimer made here that whenever we look forward to developing psychic abilities, it always has to be based on a very strong moral and ethical, but inner moral system. So we don't develop psychic abilities just for the fun of it, or just because it's entertainment, or for self-service, but we develop them as we become willing, ready, and able to serve the collective, to serve humanity. So whenever we want to heal, of course, healing is not a self-serving journey, because as we heal the inner child, the self, the mother wound, etc., we integrate more of the soul here and we become better able to serve the collective. We also contribute healing to the collective. So that is just a disclaimer. We're not looking into psychic abilities just because it is from a curiosity standpoint or entertainment, or because it's more exciting. But no, we want to get grounded in the now, be very present in the mind, create through the yoga classes, through practices such as meditation, breathing or whatever, walking, cooking, etc., really create a state where you're really present and really aware of the present moment, aware of the self, deepening your self-awareness, and from there expanding. Now, for the we've been contemplating on my website a lot the future humanity, the evolved humanity, which is way forward in our evolution, but we're creating it now as we go. And one of the most important qualities for the future human will be to have astral and etheric clairvoyance that goes into those qualities. So having absolute clarity in the astral and etheric states of being, which are more expanded states of being, or when we cross densities, really carrying that awareness, being lucid in those states, and also having a clairvoyance in those states. That will be something that we'll be developing in the future. In the now, we're developing the extra senses, even the etheric twin, which is going to have the etheric pranic organs, pranic lungs, that will be able to process prana. Those are out there concepts, but within the lessons and messages from the mystics that we've gotten, those are interesting subjects to contemplate. It is always in my mind, in Aquarian age, good to look forward into things that maybe society as a whole is not ready for, but everything starts with a small sitting of individuals that have a vision of the future that is beyond the current paradigm. So, coffee. Back to coffee. I wanted to bring something lighter here today for the public classes, because I have a lot of coffee cups. They're one of my most searched items, I know, online. So I wanted to bring a coffee cup class for you, something that you are going to be able to do in general in conjunction with my other classes, and also keep it within the ClairAlience series. So with psychic aromas, I will ask you to invoke the aroma of coffee, which potentially can bring or take you back to a place, bring memories of what you associate with coffee. The aroma of coffee typically is associated with mornings, with new beginnings, with kind of sense of being invigorated, energized, and usually with this series, I will ask you to just bring a memory that involves that aroma. Most of us have some memory related to coffee, of course, a coffee house, our grandparents are brewing coffee, a particular coffee shop you used to go to, some memory that the ClairAlience aroma can bring up. And aromas in general tend to activate the amygdala, and that is where we store positive and negative unconscious memories in the brain. By bringing them up, we are able to actually face them again and even replace them if they're negative with positive, or integrate them if they're positive, bring them into the conscious. So there is a lot of potential with healing via aromas, especially ClairAlience approach to it. Be explorative and creative with the classes. So just be free. Don't think there has to be a particular science to it, but just flow and feel and allow yourself to experience whatever is there for you to experience with these classes. But for this class, bring up the aroma or the memory of a place for you in the past that holds that aroma. And also the exercise is going to be to just experience the aroma, right? Just experience it without coffee actually being in the air. You transport yourself to a time, to a place where there is that aroma. It can be in the current time, it can be in the now. All right, with all of this being said, remember to flow with strength and ease. Starting with circular movement and very deep breath. I want you to have singular awareness of your breath here at the beginning of the class, so really tune in, turn towards the breath. And as you inhale, bring up that aroma of coffee, as if you're inhaling fresh brew coffee or coffee cake, whatever it is, it's just a coffee aroma. Circular movement. So now from the breath, drop into the body. You can close the eyes and feel the movement in the body and your presence in your body. So fully present and aware, crystal awareness of the moment via the being embodied, being, feeling, experiencing the body. Few more circular or fluid moves. So move in ways that your body invites you to move. As you tune into the body, you may want to feel the spine, the obliques, or just bring circular movements through the shoulders and hips. We're warming up and bringing movement in the body, but also experiencing the body. Let's open the arms out and we're going to do back swims. Extend the arms and draw circles backwards with your fingertips. You can continue gently moving the body. Continue with the deep breathing. Let's reverse the direction forward. And let's step the feet about hip width apart. Spread the toes open, lift the arches and create a really good connection with the earth. Bring your hands onto your belly and we're gonna do deep belly breaths, diaphragmatic. So here for this breath, I want you to inhale into the lower belly first and then fill up the lungs. And then as you exhale, flatten the belly first and then empty upward. And again, really focus on the breath, be present in exactly what you're doing. One of the most important spiritual qualities in our spiritual development is the capacity to focus on a single task. We live in a society that multitasks and it's very frazzled and lots of information and all of that, but being able to really focus on information, one source, one flowing thought or information stream or on the body or one activity is really important in developing our psychic body, psychic capacities. And we're going to inhale into the belly. Exhale, empty the belly and then the chest. And again. Exhale. One more. Exhale. And we're gonna go into a breathing exercise that I've shared once before in one of the previous classes of the December program, but it is such a good one that it's worth repeating a few times and bringing it here for the YouTube community. So we are going to, before noon or noonish, you're going to be inhaling through the left nostril and exhaling through the right, with closing with your hand the nostrils. Towards the evening, the opposite. You're gonna inhale through the right and exhale through the left. So it's gonna be different. I'm gonna inhale through the left. left is connected to the solar plexus and the spiritual heart of the human, so it helps with developing the heart and the solar consciousness, the solar body. The right is the lunar and the brain, the central brain, central nervous system, etc. And the mind. So if you're more focused on developing the heart pathway, both are important, but we really, in our current evolutionary stage, we really want to start developing the heart. We're going to inhale, for me, through the left side. If it's evening for you, through the right. So I'll inhale through the left on the count of 7, hold for 10, exhale for 9. You're going to do your own count, so that also plays into the focus component of the breath. And we are going to do 5 to 7 rounds of that. So do it at your own pace and count, but again, inhale for 7, hold for 10, exhale for 9. Let's go. Last one. And return to deep breathing. We're gonna turn on the Ujjayi breath soon. We're going to inhale the hands over the head, exhale them behind the head without clasping. Press the elbows back, chest up, open here. Clasping the hands above, and we're gonna draw a circle with the fingertips in one direction. Get into the obliques, the sides of the body, reverse it. We're bringing movement and circulation through the torso using circular movement, fluid. Let's reach side to side here and follow the movement with your gaze. So you're getting a full spinal move here. The neck is involved and the eyes are softly gazing. Pass the hands. Great, let's reach side to side. I've included this type of warm up in about 3 or 4 of the latest classes. Really enjoy a little bit of fluid warm up, elongating warm up, posture improving warm up. All right, let's bring the hips in. So you're gonna keep your knees soft and you're gonna draw figure eights with the hips and bring the shoulders in. So they're following, you're leading with the hips here and reverse it. That's also for the brain. I've been really having fun with the ClairAlience scents and aromas. There's so much to explore, like forest and moss and spring and rain and ocean and frankincense and temple and bookstore, etc. aromas. It's been fun. All right, we're done with the fluid warm-up. Step at the front, take a nice, that magnetizes, that's the magnetic stance. We tap into the magnetic currents when we stand tall. Inhale, reach over the head. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, look ahead, plank. Hold your plank, push the heels away from you. Chaturanga, upward facing dog. Chaturanga, downward dog. Inhale the right leg up, open the hip, bend the knee, lift. Lift the knee. And let's take up one-legged plank. And here we're going to take one small step with the toes on the right, two steps, three, and press it back. One, two, three. One, two, three. Really engage the core. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Step it through, high lunge. Clasp the hands and draw circles in one direction. Two, three, reverse it. Two, three, hands over the heart, twist elbow on the outside of the knee, breathe into the upper back, and when you breathe in, bring yourself to a place where there is, that's infused with the aroma of either freshly brewed coffee or coffee. And inhale, lift up. Exhale, Vinyasa. Inhale the left leg up and open. And let's take a one-legged plank. Three steps,
10 sets of that. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Step it through.
Inhale, come up and draw three circles in one direction. High lunge. And reverse. Hands in prayer. Lengthen, twist. And come up, Vinyasa.
Down dog.
Again, bringing about the sensation that there is this ephemeral aroma of coffee or place around you that is roasting, or bring about that feeling, that smell. Inhale the right leg up and open the hip, bend the knee, this time step it back while thing, lift the hips, side plank. And we're going to step the right foot in front of us and step it back and reach underneath the left shoulder with the top right hand. So that's your one, two movement. One, two, that's three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and plank. Take the right foot through, come up, high lunge. Step it at the front and take your left foot on the inside of the right thigh. Really press them into each other, feel the connection and feel how that can help you with pelvic alignment. Opening the knee. Nice deep breath and really be conscious, aware of the breath. How the breath travels, but also beyond just the air, oxygen, beyond just the lungs, feel the periphery infusing with the pranic force, etheric force. Air is information, thoughts, consciousness. The more we refine our capacity to breathe, it is said that there isn't anything that we cannot heal via proper breathing. Now the question is, how do we learn to truly, deeply breathe, be present, be aware during the breath, have the right intention, thought? It's not just a mechanical act, it's an act of really consciously being present. It's consciousness, conscious act. and plank, chaturanga, down dog. Take the left leg up and open, drop it behind while thing. Lift the hips, side plank, spread the fingers wide open, your base, and we're going to touch the toes in front, reach underneath the right shoulder, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and plank. Take the left leg to the front, high lunge. Feel the lunge and you can move or choose to be steady here, but just take a moment to feel the breath and to feel the pulse. Now with the more fluid connection to the pulse, we connect to the feminine aspect of the practice. With the more steady, we connect to the masculine aspect of the practice. All right, three pulse at the front. And again, focus, creating connection with the feet, root chakra, even root bandha, secondary bandha, connecting also with the palms of the hands, hand chakra, hand seal bandha. Feel the alignment in the body, in the pelvis, the steadiness in the mind. And again, the breath moving through the body. You can bring up the aroma of coffee. I think even people that don't like coffee, most people say they love the smell of coffee. It has something to do with beautiful new mornings, except for pregnant women. I remember I didn't like even the smell of coffee in the first trimester. And step it back, plank, vinyasa. Down dog. Inhale the right leg up. Step it through warrior one. Feel the warrior here, feel the hips, feel your ribcage, feel your breath. Continue steadying the gaze, becoming more and more present. So if you're present, theoretically you couldn't be more present if you're fully present, but there is a sense of really deepening that awareness, that sense of embodiment, so more of the soul comes in into the present and occupies the body. So we're not just kind of spaced out and into the mind, but we really become embodied. A lot of the pathway through that, for that, is through the heart, through the breath. And again, as if just air from somewhere nearby, air of coffee, just infused the air and whiffed through the air. And here we're going to step at the front again. This time wrap your left leg around the right, left arm under right up. Sit. Soften the back of the shoulder. Alright, step it back in warrior one and get your grounding and open here with the arms wrapping. And vinyasa.
Take the left leg up.
Warrior one. Experience the pose. As your breath deepens, the fluidity in the body increases, and also the presence in the body increases. That's one of the main benefits of yoga, really. It crystallizes the mind. We bring more of the unconscious into the conscious experience. Again, feel free to experiment. So if I'm steady, you can still, or if I'm fluid, you can be steady. But if I'm steady, you can feel a pulse. And let's wrap at the front. Right leg around the left. Right arm under, left up, cross, wrap, sit. And step it back, open here. And vinyasa. Inhale, open. Exhale.
Downward facing dog. Take plank.
And here we're gonna go for a combination move. So step your feet in and out, step your right foot out, reach up and feel, this is a hip opening, chest opening, twist, pose, back, step in and out, opposite side. And we're gonna keep moving here. We're gonna intensify it now, so we're gonna jump in and out, forward and back, and the same opening, and again, out, in, forward, back, left. Let's go. Let's keep going rather.
last one. And we're going to either double pat your mat, or I have this pad, use a pillow, a pad for your knees. And I'm gonna open the chest a little bit here. So reach with the right hand up and back towards the left leg and change. Open, lift, change. Grab your block if you have a block prepared, if not, without. Block between the knees and take a plank. Or sorry, between the, above the knees, between the thighs. Here, you're gonna gently bring awareness to the inner thighs, a gentle squeeze between the knees, between the legs, squeezing the block, and Mula Bandha activating the pelvic floor, the groin muscles, the groin structure, the hips. As we squeeze something between the legs, we realign the hips. From here, hold it. We're gonna tap the shoulders. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Walk your hands to the back. Take chair. With that gentle squeeze. Mula Bandha. And let's go again. Plank, shoulder taps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Walk it back. Chair. One more. Steady, 1. Chair. And coming out, standing with the block, come onto the tippy toes, drop onto the heels. That anti-aging exercise I've been incorporating into the classes, and I have a post on it on Instagram. Ground reaction force creates vibration through the body, through the bones, and especially beneficial for ankles, calves. Knees, of course. Thighs, hips. So you're gonna lift and drop down. Lift, drop down, lift. Lift. All right, time for wall sits. Still with your block, sit on a wall. Squeeze the block. Pull the belly in, lower back to the wall. Squeeze. Relax. Squeeze. Relax, squeeze, relax, squeeze, relax. And now with aromas, back to chair. With aromas, even the positive aroma, I was discussing this in my last class, so I'm gonna repeat some of it. Excuse me if it's a repeat, but even with positive aromas, they may not be registered in the memory bank, in the
Amygdala is a positive event because oftentimes we're unconscious of certain things around us, such as in this case aroma. So for example, if there is a particular flower, let's say roses blossoming, and something negative happens to you, 20 years down the line you can develop an allergy to that flower, because every time you smell it, it reminds you of, like, say you got in a fight or something traumatic as a child happened during the time of those flowers blossoming. So they're not always, not every good aroma is a positive aroma, but with this exercise we bring more of the unconscious into the conscious and an opportunity to face it and eventually replace it. And a negative memory, generally, we cannot erase it, but we can change the perspective of how we perceive it or replace the memory, because we don't remember things correctly often. And even if we do, we can replace how we perceived it. All right, still with the block. You can take a little break here from the block. Come on to all fours. And a few cat-cows to reset. And we're gonna move into a core interval. So with these exercises, we just become more aware of ourselves, besides more focused and starting to branch out into higher senses. All right, block between the thighs. Walk your knees a little closer to you than they are for all fours, and you're gonna pull the knees slightly off the floor, pull the belly in, round the back slightly, and really draw in, mini stomach vacuum. The inner thighs are engaged. They're squeezing the block gently. You don't have to over squeeze though, just a gentle squeeze. Release. We're gonna do a few more of those. Exhale, lift. Release. Exhale. Release, two more. Release, take plank. Side plank on the left hand. Flex your feet, draw the toes in. Activate the inner thighs. Reach up, reach over the head, then up, then under. Let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six. I'll give you less reps, but this is a coffee cup, so it's the full 10. And plank, change. Let's go. One, steady. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9 and 10. And you can sit. You can sit down on your booty. Again, with the block, squeeze here, and we're going to reach side to side. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lower down. These ones are my favorite, so I'm gonna include them. side crunches, very effective. Few reps really can build your obliques. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Change. A very gentle squeeze of the block. The block is there for you to activate your adductors, but really this is balancing the entire pelvis, the hips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And lay down. Pelvic tilt, and you're going to bring the hands above your shoulders, press the hands together, yeah, they can clasp, and you're going to drop the shoulders down, keep the shoulders down, reach over the head, squeeze the block, and stomach vacuum. So exhale and let's go. Two more. Again, a whiff of coffee, ephemeral. One last. We're moving into another exercise for balancing the hips and shoulders. Here, regular, normal spine alignment. You're not going to do a pelvic tilt. Keep your spine in a just regular position. And we're going to drop the shoulders again. Same thing, reach above the head, drop the shoulders down. Contact with the floor, the shoulders don't remove themselves from the floor, and reach over the head as far down as you can without removing the shoulders. Gentle squeeze for the of the block. Release, come back, hands back up. I want to do one more. So here, observe the connection hip shoulders. One more. Gentle squeezes of the blocks, and we're gonna do the Pilates 100, although we're not gonna do 100, but that's the move. Mula Bandha. Great, lift your legs up, still the block between the thighs, and we're going to do an up crunch and a booty lift. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. And extend the legs, reach over the head, flex the feet, pull the toes back. Grab your right wrist with the left hand, keep your shoulders down, and reach over to one side. Side bends in a prone position, opposite side. So we're really elongating the torso here, so you can feel really tall after class. and remove the block for now. We're gonna need it one more time. We're going to do scissors with elongated straight legs, hands together, reaching on the side of the legs. One, two, three. Ten. And plow. Shoulder stand. And lower down, bring the block back in. Place the block underneath your tailbone. You can place either the long side of the block, which is what I've done, or you can just place it on the short side of the block. Either way, it will work. We're gonna stretch the psoas here. So extend the right leg. Make sure you're steady here on the block, and bring your left knee in so that we're stretching, isolating and stretching the right psoas. One more whiff of the coffee and whatever it brings about. The capacity, the power of yoga is really that we can use it as a tool to heal, because even when we have, which a lot of human behavior is ruled by emotional trauma, we cannot fix the mind with the mind. So we cannot affect our experiences through the mind, how the mind perceived experiences. But what we can do is change the patterns in the body, in the breath, in how we hold the muscular system. From that, from the breath, we affect the mind, and then the mind can experience things in a different way once it's in a calm state. So we can really experience emotional healing via working through the body route, the breathing route. Change sides. If you're on the long side of the mat, make sure it doesn't, on the block, make sure it doesn't fall for you. But it gives you a little more lift here. Also I like to stretch this using a yoga wheel as well. It's a little taller and steadier, and it gives you that rounded . So breathe into your psoas. It starts from the spine and it moves through the pelvis, through the groin. It symbolizes, symbolically it holds a lot of trauma, because it is the deepest muscle in the body. So if you look at things from that perspective, kind of the Louis Hay perspective, or how things speak to us via how they look or what they symbolize, etc. You can see why here, first and second chakra, why we can store so much in the tissue. Release the block and let's go for a supine twist, left knee across. Releasing a sense of release. So now instead of inhaling, coffee, exhale fully. Just feel your body exhaling, not just the breath, but really releasing, letting go. Surrender. Opposite side. Soften. And you can lay down. Make yourself comfortable for Shavasana. Bringing about again the aroma of, or the association of, a coffee aroma. A morning, the beginning of a day. The flower essence of coffee is used for supporting us in feeling, experiencing freedom and liberation. From the plant allies, when we look at their flowers, if they have a flower, we can learn a lot about the mission of the plant. So that is why I often bring about the flower essences and how they affect our psyche. But here we're gonna, in this ClairAlience experience of the aroma of coffee, we're gonna also bring about the feeling of joy, being exuberant, free, expanded, the sense of expansion, no limits, just expanded feeling of joy, sunny, a sunny experience, a sunny vision, visual. And if you can hold that experience, vision, frequency for just even a second, that is it, you tap into that frequency. The longer you hold it, it's a good concentration, focus exercise, but just experience that. A sense of joy, and it's deep within your psyche, deep within yourself. A kind of expansion, beginning, a promise for something new. It could be any memory. It could be a ski vacation and everybody was drinking coffee at the lodge and you just had this anticipation about the day that's coming, that's gonna be a lot of fun and adventure or just anything of that nature you can bring about here. I'll leave you on your own. But bring about anything. And if for some reason it is not a positive memory for you, if there is a different sense, then bring it and sit with it, face it, explore it. And I've been using emotion code, and there is a lot of you can bring about an emotion. There is a technique that it's used to release it just by bringing it about, so you can hear, see what arises for you. Generally, I want here for us to experience joy for this class, but don't feel that something is wrong if you experience something else. If you can generate on your own the experience of joy within yourself, for no particular reason, you just have that capacity within yourself to generate expansion, joy, anticipation, and just the sense of a new beginning, do that. But if you want to experience whatever it is within you that is arising, know that that is right for you to do right now. Come back to the class and experience joy next time. So with that, bring about that sense of joy or whatever else it is for you, and stay with it for a few moments, just within your own heart, within your own self, mind, and experience it. Just invigorate your body, your cells with that visual. And remember to flow with strength and ease. Namaste.